Lifetime.
For jeans, for rope. But you explain.
Well, hemp is a product that at one time it was the product most grown in this country up until 1937. It was very legal. You made clothes out of it. The first Levi's was made out of hemp. You made paper out of it. The original Constitution of the United States was written on hemp paper. They talk about saving trees. If you, 1 acre of hemp is equivalent to 4 acres of trees. So you talk about saving the rainforest. I mean, this is, and it's also edible. There's been, it's a high protein food, similar to soybean. Mm-hmm. It's a great medicine.
Now, let me, excuse my ignorance, the hemp aspect of the marijuana plant, like if you eat it, you won't get any kind of high or anything. It's another part that you smoke, right?
The leaf.
Yeah.
Is the part that they smoke and use in various ways. They call it cannabis. And up until 1937, it was used in a lot of patent medicines in this country. But also in 1938, in the February edition of Popular Mechanics, if you folks would like to research it, there's an article in there that says, a brand new bumper crop for the American family farmer. $1 billion crop. And it was the hemp industry, which the American people had always been growing it, but and using it for clothing, and using it for medicine, and using it for paper, and also using it for energy. It can be converted into energy. And all these things combined was a big problem to the petrochemical industry, DuPont and those people. DuPont was received their patent in 1937, the same year that the hemp industry was shut down and made illegal.
Oh, I smell a rat. Yeah, so you think basically there are a lot of people who profit from the hemp industry being non-existent?
Of course.
Oh. That's interesting.
It is.
That's very interesting. You smoked a joint on the roof of the White House one time, didn't you?
I read that.
Yeah, you read that too?
I read that too.
That never happened?
It was a long time ago. You know, it's that short-term memory they talk about.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, gosh. You're doing another song for us tonight. What's
I'd love
title?
To. This is it's a song that, it's a blues song, and it sort of gives me a chance to show off the band. And I'm very proud of these guys. We play a lot of dates together all the time, and we're very close, but I never get a chance to brag on them. Yeah. And I'd like to do this blues number.
So you're going to let everybody have a little bit?
Absolutely.
Give the drummer some,
yes,
top player some, bass player some, and give them that number again.
1-800-IRS-TAPE.
Yeah, you can get a tape and help Willie in the process.
Hey,
we'll be right
you,
back.
I appreciate that.
Yeah. This is Willie Nelson.
Well, I woke up this morning, looked out my door. I could tell my milk cow, I could tell by the way she lows. So if you see my milk cow, won't you please drive her on? Cause I ain't had no milk butter since my cow's been gone. Now you have got to treat me right, baby, day by day. Get out your little prayer book and get out on your knees and pray, cause you're gonna need my help someday. And you're going to be sorry that you treated me this way. Little sister Bobby, play the piano. Thank you. good woman to get along with you. And now I'm gonna tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna quit my crying, I'm gonna leave you alone. And if you don't think I'm leaving, you can just count the days that I'm gone. Cause you ain't gonna see, you ain't gonna see my sweet face no more.